those of you who know my photography, one thing I love to photograph is food. So let's go ahead and edit a food image inside of ON1 Photo. I'm going to select the salmon image and then click on Develop on the right. Now this is an image of some salmon on a cedar plank and it's sitting on a grill. So it wasn't an over-stylized shoot. I pretty much just made sure that the oranges looked really nice stacked on the salmon. But the light is really good and it even has some really neat kind of steam and smoke swirling up above. For the most part, processing food photographs is relatively simple. It's a matter of adding a nice balanced color, some contrast and exposure, maybe a vignette, and a little bit of sharpening. So I'm going to show you all of those things here inside of both develop and effects. I'm going to start out with the color section and I'm just going to increase the temperature slider to the right to add some warmth. And I have it at about 14 and that looks like it's a pretty good setting. For the tone, I'm going to click auto to see what ON1 thinks will look good. And that actually did a pretty decent job. I'm going to go through some of the settings and make some minor adjustments. So I'm going to increase the contrast just a little bit. I'll decrease the highlights to try and get rid of some of the highlights on those oranges. It might have just been photographed that way, so those highlights on the oranges may just have to stay there. I'm going to increase the shadows a little bit more. And let's see what the whites do if I move it to the left. And I think that looks good. There are some little blemishes on the oranges. I'm not opposed to having things look a little bit messy in my food, but I think I might go ahead and remove some of these. So I'm going to zoom in and I'm going to select the perfect eraser. I'm going to make sure my brush size is just a little bit larger than the area that I want to remove and then sweep across to get rid of some of these little black dots. So I'll get the ones that are inside the orange. Takes a moment for each of them to apply. And then I'll get these on the outside. And let's see if that one does a good job. And that did all right. You can always go over those areas again if you want to kind of refine that correction. And last but not least, I'll get this little blob here on the bottom. And that looks good. So I'll zoom back out. And I think that did a nice job of cleaning up that portion of the image. I'd like to also add some saturation and some vibrance, but I really only want it to affect the salmon portion. I'm worried that if I move, and let me go ahead and try, if I move that vibrance slider to the right, it's going to oversaturate those oranges. So let me reset that vibrance slider. And instead, I'm going to go over to the local adjustments. I'm going to reset the exposure so it's back to zero. I'll increase that vibrance slider pretty far to the right. I'm going to reduce the brush size, and then I'm just going to brush over that salmon area. Now, if you press the O key, you can actually see where you are painting, and that makes it a little bit easier for the local adjustments because it may not always be obvious where you're brushing with some of these types of settings. So I'll just keep painting until I get all of that salmon area, or most of it, I should say. It doesn't have to be a perfect mask. Okay, I'll press O again. And now let me toggle this adjustment on and off. And that looks really nice. I'm actually going to see what happens if I increase the saturation. I'm not going to go too far because that might clip those colors. I might even increase the temperature to the right as well. So let me toggle this on and off and see. And that did a really great job of making that red of the salmon really pop. I'm finished editing in develop, so now let's take it into effects and add a couple of filters to just kind of finish off the image. I'll click on effects on the right, and then I'll click the add filter button, and I'm going to start out by adding a filter. So I have that photo filter applied. In this little more dropdown, I'm going to select the polarizer, which looks good, but it's a little too intense, or not a little too intense, it's a lot too intense. So I'm going to reduce that opacity down to around 50%. We'll do a quick toggle of that. And that looks great. That's a really good filter to use for food. I'm going to minimize this panel, and then I'm going to add another filter. This time I'd like to add some sharpening. So I'm going to select the sharpening filter. And in this more dropdown, I'm going to choose high pass. I tend to use high pass in Photoshop, so I've just kind of become accustomed to using it in other places as well. Now, when adding sharpening to an image, you want to make sure that if you have an image with a blurry background, just like I do here, that you don't add sharpening to the entire image. So you want to apply it selectively. And in effects, I can, of course, mask out individual layers. In this case, I'm going to use the masking bug. So I'm going to click on the masking bug in the toolbar on the left. I'm going to choose the vignette, and I'm going to select edges. The edges setting ensures that I have an inverted vignette so that the visible area is in the center. Now I'm going to click in my image, and I'm going to resize and even rotate using this little knob in the middle there so that it's only affecting kind of that plane of focus. Let me press the O key so you can see what it is actually affecting. So now it's a little bit easier to place this because I can actually see that area that's going to be sharpened. I can even increase the feather if I want. In this case, I don't know if I need to. I'll press O again to hide that mask preview, and I think that's looking good. I'm going to minimize this layer, and I'll finish this image with a vignette. So I'll click Add Filter, and then I'll select the vignette filter from the list. I'm going to choose Big Softy, but I don't want the vignette to be this intense, so I'm going to reduce the opacity, and I have it at about 60%. That might be a little too much. I think I'm going to move it down closer to about 45 or so. And that looks great. All right, that's it for this image. I'm going to go ahead and click on Browse to bring my final image back into Browse.